Let us start. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. In the waters of baptism, Anne Marie died with Christ and rose with him in new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night,
life Anne Marie cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet her with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Anne Marie received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. My friends, I welcome you to St. Bridget's this morning. We come to comfort Hugh and his family with our prayers and by our presence here. So let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, Our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Immersively grant that through this mystery, your servant Anne-Marie, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated, and I invite our readers to come forward.
The first reading is a reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." This is the word of the Lord.
The second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be with the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise. And then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. This is the word of the Lord. We stand to greet the gospel.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Each time we hear the gospel proclaimed, Jesus is inviting us to listen to him, to listen with our hearts. In the gospel, he assures us, "I shall return to take you with me." It is our Christian faith that on Monday morning last, as Anne-Marie was surrounded by her loving family, the Lord returned to take her with him. At the same time, he said to us, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me." And so, sad of heart, but with trusting hearts, with this funeral mass, we commend Anne-Marie into the hands of the Lord. On another occasion, Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. For I am gentle and humble in heart." He is indeed a gracious Lord. And Anne-Marie, by her natural disposition, but also in response to her Christian faith, reflected the same graciousness. She was gentle, soft-spoken, considerate, and blessed too with a kindly but mischievous sense of humour. A quote from an old song called Gentle Annie gives us a picture of Anne-Marie. Fair and lovely Annie, your gentle ways have won me. You bring peace and joy and laughter everywhere. Where you go, the sunshine follows. You're a breath of spring and winter, and my heart and soul are always in your care. Today we gather here, holding Anne-Marie's family in our prayers and love. We know their sense of loss is great, because Anne-Marie was very much the heart of the home. When Hugh and Anne-Marie first met, it was just love from then on. They married in 1969, 54 years ago. Work entailed frequent moves between here and England, and for Anne-Marie, each time, lovingly setting up a new home. On behalf of all, I offer our sincere sympathy to Hugh and to his family, Gary, Karen, and Catherine, together with their spouses, Claire, Hugh, and David, to the beloved grandchildren, Daniel, Maria, Evelyn, Kathleen, Maeve, and Hannah, Anne-Marie's brothers, Sean and Kevin, and her sisters, Kathleen, Eileen, Rose, Margaret, and Pauline. The extraordinary blessing that our Christian faith brings to us is this: no matter what befalls us in life, we know that God never abandons us. Should we ever doubt, all we need to do is look at the crucifix. God did not abandon Jesus, even when he was nailed to a cross. God will not abandon us. St. Paul, in today's second reading, writes, "We want you to be quite certain about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them like the other people who have no hope." We pray that the many happy memories that you have of Anne-Marie at home, on holiday, in Buncrana, together with your faith in Jesus the Lord, will in time lift your spirits and fill your hearts with joy once more. You ask that I express a particular word of gratitude to all who cared for Anne-Marie in her illness. Dr. Una Sheehy in the hematology and oncology teams in the City Hospital, the Northern Ireland Hospice Community Team, the physio from Macmillan Support, and the Knockbreda District nursing staff. When the need was great, yours have been comforting hands. A great saint said that on earth, Christ has no hands but yours. The prophet Isaiah, in today's first reading, presents an idealized picture of heaven as a gathering for a great joyous feast on a mountainside. Anne-Marie might gently contradict him, suggesting that there is nowhere more heavenly than Buncrana and Inishowen. It is to there that we bring her mortal body and lay it in the graveyard of St. Mary's Church, Cock Hill. How consoling are the words of the psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. He guides me through the valley of darkness. I do not fear. You are there. In the Lord's house shall I dwell forever and ever. May the Lord Jesus, in whom Anne-Marie placed her trust, now lead her into the house of the Father. May she know the happiness of heaven's company and rest in peace. Amen. We stand for the prayer of the faithful. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to His.
In baptism, Anne-Marie was given the pledge of eternal life. May she now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the family of Anne-Marie, that in these difficult and dark days they may be sustained by their faith and by their knowledge that they will be reunited with Anne-Marie one day in God's heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all the faithful departed, that they may see God face to face in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all here present, that our remembrance of Anne-Marie may be a source of comfort and strength. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all doctors, nurses, and carers, and particularly those who were so good to Anne-Marie during her illness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayer of your people. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Let us stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of Anne-Marie, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Donal, our apostolic administrator, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember Anne-Marie, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when, from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever. Let us stand. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
To me,
Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, Anne Marie may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. We come to the prayers of farewell. And during these prayers, we will reverence Anne Marie, first with the holy water of baptism. Our pilgrimage began in baptism, and now we pray it has brought her face to face with God. Then with incense, in life, we are called to be temples of God's Spirit. And the incense rising up, a symbol of our prayers rising up to God. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Anne Marie, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Anne Marie again and enjoy her friendship. Although we will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Saints of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive our soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Anne Marie in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Anne Marie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with Anne Marie forever. Amen. In peace, Let us take Anne-Marie to her place of rest.